Welcome to all children. In previous class we have completed lesson 1, isn't it? Okay, now we are going to see the lesson 2, food and health. What is mean by health? Say the answer. What is health? Okay, health means we need to keep our body fit, isn't it? Right. So health is a state of complete physical and mental well-being. Okay, to stay healthy we should exercise regularly and have a balanced diet and maintain hygiene. Then components of food. So we have eat different types of food, isn't it? So which gives us energy to do work and play. Food contains, these food items contains different some essential substances, so that is called nutrients. See here, vitamins, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, minerals, these are nutrients, different nutrients. So first carbohydrates, we are going to see about the carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is called energy giving food. So it is otherwise called energy giving food because we get more energy from the carbohydrates. Okay, so it has two types, sugar and starch are two main types of carbohydrates. Okay, so some food items it has the carbohydrates, cereals, fruits, corn, potato and honey are some sources of carbohydrates. Okay, for doing a lot of physical work we need carbohydrates. So you are children, you people are playing no every day, so you need more energy, isn't it, for playing and doing some activities. So you should take carbohydrate food. Then fats. So fat is otherwise called as energy giving food. Like carbohydrate, fats also give us energy. In fact, fats give more energy than carbohydrates. Okay, so what are the sources of food which contains fats? Vegetable oil, milk, butter, ghee, cheese. Okay, so these are the some sources of fats. Okay, so we have eating too much of fat means what happen, it is, it can be harmful to us. Okay, so it lead us obesity can cause diabetes and heart disease also. Okay, so we should avoid to take a lot of fat food items. Okay, so fats and carbohydrates are called energy giving food. Next one is proteins. Proteins are help us to grow, so we need proteins for building our muscles. Okay, so to build our muscles, proteins are very very important. So proteins are also called growth of food. So it is otherwise called growth of food and bodybuilding food. So what are the sources means, milk and its products, chicken and fish, eggs, pulses and soya bean. So these are the food items rich in proteins. Okay, so growing children like you need more proteins, so you should take the protein food items, then only you will grow. The next one is the vitamins and minerals. So vitamins help our body fight against diseases and keep us healthy and fit. Okay, so vitamins we need very very small amount only, like fruits, eggs, fishes and green leafy vegetables are sources of vitamins. Okay, so only a little amount of vitamin is required. So minerals, so it is keep our body healthy and fit. Okay, so like iron, calcium, iodine, phosphorus are the important minerals needed our body. Okay, so leafy vegetables and fruits, milk, egg and salt are rich in sources of minerals. So these food items has the minerals. So if lack of minerals in our body means it may cause diseases. For example, if it is a lack of iron in our body means what happened, it will cause a disease called anemia. So and lack of iodine causes goiter. okay. So vitamins and minerals are called protective foods because they protect our body. Okay, next one is roughage. So roughage means it is nothing but it is a fibrous content food. Okay, so they help us get rid of undigested food. Some sources of roughage are grains, green vegetables and fruits, right? Then water. So it is very, very important, isn't it? Very important component of our body. So our body is made up of 2/3 of our body is made up of water. Okay, so water help is removing our body waste through sweat and urine regulation also. Okay, so we should drink 6 to 8 glasses of water every day. So now summer season, no, so you should drink water, more water. Then balanced diet. So what is mean by balanced diet? So every day we have take food, isn't it? So in every day food items we should take them all the nutrients. Okay, carbohydrates, minerals and proteins, vitamins, all the things we should take. So that is called a balanced diet. A diet that contains the right proportion of different nutrients, roughage and water needed for the healthy functioning of our body is called the balanced diet. So here 40% of food and vegetables we need, and then 25% of carbohydrate foods and 25% of protein food and 10% of fats, isn't it? So we should take vegetables, fruits and vegetables. Okay, so in high amount we should take fruits and vegetables, so it is keep our body healthy manner. Okay, right children? So hereafter you want to eat a balanced diet every day. Then you have some activity. Okay, so here in each group, 6 groups are there. In each group, it has the one balanced diet missing. Okay, you want to identify the diet, which one is missing. Okay, first one, boiled potato, cabbage, carrot. One is missing. So which nutrient is missing there? Right, protein. So we add fish. So first one, fish. Second one, pizza. So which is made up of cheese and tomato. So which nutrient is need? Vitamins and minerals. Okay, very good. So for this vitamins and minerals, we should add the salad. Okay. The next, third one, rice and meat. Okay, so which is left there? Vitamins and minerals. So carrot, we add the carrot. Then fourth group, chicken, peas. Okay, so which is left there? A carbohydrate food nutrient is left, so we should add the potato. Okay, in fifth group, spring onion, carrot, bread. So which is left there? Which nutrient is left? Protein. Very good.